right here in Atlanta, DragonCon, celebrating its 25th year. Now, you might not have been out there in the parade, you might not understand what's going on, but let me tell you, this thing is a big deal. We've got up to 45,000 diehard fans of science fiction, fantasy, movies, comics, video games, all expected to attend. You see the atmosphere here. They're dressed up as memorable characters from comic books or movies. They're simply there to catch up on the latest culture news and gossip.
DragonCon is the nerd Super Bowl, and the parade is the shining event of the nerd Super Bowl. It is the most fun the nerds can have all year.
All right, and join me to help give me an education at this. Dan Carroll, he's a spokesman for this huge and still growing event. Fair to say it's still growing?
Absolutely.
And also an actor, director, Claire Kramer. You might recognize the name and the face, but it is still fair to say most famously from Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
That's correct. Especially in this culture, the geek, the nerd culture, they are very passionate about Joss Whedon and Buffy, so that's what they come out to see.
Of course, a lot of people might remember you from Bring It On as well.
That's true, yes.
That would kind of put you on the map.
Absolutely. That's my first major project.
Okay, now you all tell me, is it fair to say, just like that person said, the nerd Super Bowl, is that a compliment or is that an insult or is that a right on?
That's an absolute compliment. I would say geek mecca is another description you might use. I mean, it's just a phenomenon that has grown and grown over the 25 years. And it just really brings out everyone who's passionate about sci-fi, fantasy, you know.
And from an insider's point of view, we're looking at an event that brings 1,700 volunteers together to welcome 45,000 attendees to Atlanta. We have 400 guest stars coming in, and we have grown exponentially the past few years.
You all help me and help our viewers. Now, we know a lot of this is huge, and it wouldn't be around for 25 years if you weren't doing something right. We got a couple of characters over here. You all explain who I'm seeing there, who these two characters are, but the other part of it is a lot of people think, what makes grown, educated, college-educated, professional people go out and dress up like this for a weekend? So you, either one of you, explain.
Absolutely. Go ahead and take these, because I drag these guys up out of bed. We have Cliff Tunnell, who's actually an attorney. He's a lawyer here in Atlanta.
The guy there on the left.
That's correct. Dressed as Steampunk Ash. Steampunk is a new fad within... it's not a fad, it's a new... theme within Phantom, where the fans create their own characters based on a Jules Verne sort of technology, and he's taken a classic character from the Army of Darkness character and brought it back to the 1890s.
All right, who's the lady there?
That is Whitney Jones, and she is representing Slytherin, one of the houses of Harry Potter. Then the fans, we modify our costumes, and this one represents her lifestyle and her way of being.
Right. Well, you help me here as well. And a lot of, I mean, actors, actresses, we've talked to people from DragonCon before. This can be your bread and butter, quite frankly, because there are some places where you can go to DragonCon, and they love you, they will support you, and this can really help someone like you, your career, go along. People might not even realize it, but
absolutely. The fans of the genre are extremely loyal, they're extremely dedicated and giving, and they will, if they're passionate about a project that you as an actor have been in, they will follow your career and follow every project that you've done, and it's really, the sense of loyalty is amazing. You know, and you look at the economic climate right now, and you see so much depression across the country. Something like DragonCon almost makes that seem obsolete. I mean, this is a genre where people can come in, there's a sense of escapism, there's a sense of fantasy, and that, like, suspension of disbelief. And I think that's one of the things that draws such a large number of people out to an event like DragonCon.
How do you continue to grow, to get the word out, get more people brought in, or do you just have kind of a hardcore base of fans who are going to be there, and that's just what it's going to be?
Well, of course, we have folks who've been with us all 25 years. This is our 25th anniversary. But we also are constantly looking for new areas within the fandom, within the geek community. A few years ago, we introduced steampunk, like our gentleman we saw, and it's exploded. It's actually the alternate history track is one of the largest tracks we have. This year, we saw a trend developing, and we added a track for tween TV shows. So those people who are fans of iCarly, Sunny with a Chance, and I'm really embarrassed that I'm actually naming these. These shows are represented by our new
in Kaleidoscope track.
All right, then. Both of you all consider yourselves, would you call yourselves geeks? That's a compliment, is it? You use the word geek.
Absolutely. I embrace the title, and I'm actually launching a new website January 1st called Geek Nation.
Geek Nation!
It plans on encompassing all the positive aspects of geek culture under one umbrella on the internet.
Well, Dan, girl, I appreciate both of you all coming in, helping me and the viewers
understand,
and maybe you'll get us out there dressed up one of these days.
All right.
The event continues throughout the weekend right here in Atlanta. But thank you guys so much for being here, and thanks to those two for dragging them in, as you said, this morning as well. Thanks so much. We're at the top of the hour. We're going to reset things here. And